All right, here goes. This is what we're making. It's a basket thingy to hold all your junk. Here's another one I made, and I have been using it perfect for carting around all of my crochet stuff. We live in a tiny house, or a smallish house, and I don't have a proper studio, so it's good to have things to bundle all in. This one was made with raffia as the core, a big fat size 10 crochet hook, and this is some coconut fiber. This also, the black, is coconut fiber. And then this that I've got was some jute. I think actually hemp twine I had a ball of. So it's not quite as firm as the coconut fiber. And if I'd have thought this out better, I should have put the stripy jupe as the base and the fiber as the top, as the walls. But it doesn't matter because it's still quite sturdy anyway. This giant one is this big. And this was a 100 gram ball of fiber from String Harvest. This I'm pretty sure was a 25 gram, and then this was probably similar. So I don't know how many meters they are, I'm sorry. And I didn't even measure out how much raffia I used. But here's what we're going to use. I went looking and realized I don't have any jute or anything left over at the moment. So I'm going to use this, which is a recycled cotton and actually denim, like jeans. It's much, much thinner and less sturdy than the others. So the basket itself won't be as sturdy, but that is okay. I'll probably make it a bit smaller anyway. And these raffias are approximately 50 grams each. I'll see and I'll let you know how many I end up using. But again, it depends on how big you want to make your thing, really, doesn't it? These I dyed with turmeric and they smell beautiful, if you like that earthy turmeric smell. So, here goes. I'm going to assume that you know crochet basics, but I'm going to show you anyway. And once you're working, if you need me to refilm any bits, just let me know. Sometimes I can just do a quick stories, say an Instagram or something. With raffia, don't cut or waste any bits because you can use it all. If you're doing basket making or whatever, we used it to wrap up all our presents for Christmas. It's actually, florists use it a lot, so that's not unusual. And all the little scraps you can use when you do, say like use a smaller crochet hook and make something with all the scraps woven in and all the different colors, makes it really lovely. So this has a really nice sort of sturdiness. That's why I'm using raffia as the core. You could also use fabric. You can tear up strips of fabric in like old sheets or anything really into strips, or you could cut up t-shirt fabric and use that. T-shirt fabric's really nice to crochet with, but it's much softer. It doesn't have as much I'm just gonna keep getting up to make sure I'm still in shot. It doesn't have as much stability. So we begin with a slip knot. And basically, those of you who have done the my basket weaving workshop, this is a little similar, but a little bit different because you're working with crochet. But basically, once we've got the slip knot, the tail is here, all of the yarn is here. Hold it however you like. This is how I hold mine. I have this bit here so I can guide my finger, and the tail comes through mine like this. But you'll find that this gets a little bit different than regular crochet just because of the working around something. So to begin, I've got a little bit of raffia about this fat. How many strands? 20 strands maybe. Remember, we're working with a fat crochet hook and we are making a fat thing, a big thick sort of thing. So we're starting like this. Put the crochet hook around and bring through your yarn, yarn over hook, and pull off both loops. And that's your first stitch done. Wrap your hook around, bring your yarn through. You have two loops on your hook, yarn over, and both loops off. Wrap it around, bring through. Now we need to do this enough times to make it into a sort of circle. Not too loose, not too tight. Don't make it too tight because then it makes it harder for the next round. So that's what I'm aiming to get, like that. Now this is very soft and actually a bit slippy. If you use jute or hemp or the coconut fiber, it has a lot more grip. So you'll find it won't, this is slipping around quite a lot. Which is fine, it's not a worry. What we're making is not going to be perfect. We're using big chunky crochet hook. All right, that's probably good. I can twist it around into shape. But I would definitely suggest, if you can get some jute or hemp or that coconut fiber is really lovely, but something similar to that. Now, once you've gone all the way around, the tops of your stitches are sitting on the top like that. We're going to join it and we will do one that wraps around both of the tails. And then I'm going to go into this very first chain stitch, which you didn't want to pull it too tight because then it's too hard to get into. And slip stitch it together. That's your circle. From now on, we're not doing a circle, we're doing a spiral. This little tail bit can just hide away inside there and you won't even know it. So from now on, we're going loop through. Now we're going to start to, I need to do a couple more before I can go around. So I'm going to do a couple more loop arounds and then the spiral can start to spiral on itself. Oh, the light just changed. I hope the phone's picking it up. I think we're about to get a storm. Okay, now I've spiraled back around enough. Now what I'm going to do is, see this stitch here? From this first row, these are your crochet stitches. There's two little bits. With normal crochet, you would go through both, but with this one, and especially if you're using a fat chunky yarn, just go through the back of the stitch. Round through there, pull the yarn through the back of the stitch, around, yarn over, off to. And you go on to the next stitch. Just into the back of the stitch. Now, if some of the raffia gets caught up, it's totally okay. It's going to happen. Now, as you're going, it's a little bit of a working out. There's no particular pattern. Sometimes you actually might have to go twice into one stitch. Because we're making a spiral that's getting bigger and bigger, you need to determine for yourself if you need to add stitches. So as you get out, you're going to have to add stitches. If you kept on doing the same stitches, it would just go up, up, up. So to make it sit flat, you actually have to add stitches. So perhaps every second stitch, you will need to do 2 stitches into the 1 stitch. But that will just start to see how it feels when you're working it. If you need to do more, then you do more. And mine is looking a little bit awkward at this stage because of this soft yarn, but it'll be fine once it gets going. Sometimes that's just what happens, especially with the baskets. I do find they do look a bit awkward. Now you can do this with anything. You can do a fine thinner crochet hook and use some very beautiful fine fibers and wrap it around say just a couple of strands of raffia, or even where's that other thing I had? Even wrap it around something like this, or some seagrass matting or something like that. For those of you who don't... Oh, did you see that lightning? If it starts to... Well, there you go. If it starts to storm, I'll have to turn it off because you probably won't hear me. But I'll keep on going a bit to show you. And might have to finish this tomorrow. For those of you who know String Harvest, which is where I get my raffia from and a lot of my fibers, Cass makes some very beautiful baskets using this same technique, but with very fine fibers and fine crochet hooks. I just really love this fat basketing. So I'm just stitching into the back of that stitch. Remember, you just go through one loop, pulling it through. Basically, I am just doing this same stitch all the way. No tricky stitches. Really, where the trickiness comes is the roughness of the fiber. So this one particularly was really rough. You can see all the hairs poking up. So the roughness of the fiber, and it's a little bit awkward sort of working it, but it's not tricky. Isn't this yellow divine? So I'm adding 2 stitches in as I need to every stitch, and I am going in a spiral. I'm almost back to this bit. I'm not going to go a circle and do that slip stitch to finish the circle. I'm just going to keep going in a spiral, so I don't know particularly where the beginning is. Until we get up to needing to form the walls, it doesn't matter. It's starting to rain now. Summer storms here. This is what we've been having. It's all hot and sticky and I didn't get to go for a swim. I might go swimming in the rain. What do you think? I know many people film in a studio in perfect conditions. That is not me. It is not how I work. It is not how I live my life. My studio is an absolute crazy land at the moment, and I daren't even barely walk in except to find my supplies. This is my veranda I'm sitting on. But you know, life isn't perfect, and I have to do my work around the summer storms and around the crazy, and my work is just it's the way I am. So what I'm saying is, I'm sorry that it's storming. I'm not sorry that it's storming. I am saying I'm not apologizing for the way that I work. Actually, that's what I'm saying. So you can see here, it's getting a little bit loose, and that's because of the yarn that I'm working with, as opposed to the technique. So what I might do, well, if I had a smaller crochet hook, I could go down a size, but I don't. So what I might in fact do is double up my yarn and use 2 strings of yarn. And that'll make it a bit thicker. thicker. I'm also getting to the point where I need to add some more raffia. So to do that, just grab another little bundle, get the end and fold it into a point, and poke it into the middle. And then hold on to it as you're working, and it'll just stay in. So I'm just going to add this one in, and I'll weave the tail in later. And that'll give me a little bit more stability to it. Make it a little bit thicker. I don't think I got in that stitch. Already I can see the little bit of difference. I also will need to just pull it a little bit tighter when I'm stitching. I find that sometimes the awkwardness of showing you and sitting a bit awkwardly to sit under the camera properly often makes my work not as quite right as it could be. This tail here, I'm just catching it up into here, which is easier now than weaving it in after. So you can see we're working in a spiral, and really all I'm doing is just going into the back of the stitch rather than the whole stitch. Now, two reasons for that. One, you'll start to see this pretty little pattern develop where the top of the stitch sits on top. But the other reason, the main reason, is with the thicker fibres that you'll be using, it's actually, I found with the coconut fibre particularly, it was really hard to get into two stitches. So if you're doing a much finer work, you might be able to go into two stitches, but the going into the back of the stitch makes it sit a little bit flatter beside it as well. I'll just pull it. Isn't this yellow with the blue? Quite lovely. So you always want to make sure that you have enough raffia that it's staying the same thickness throughout. That's sometimes what I know people forget to add the raffia in. But you'll end up then with some skinny bits and some fat bits, and not a problem.